Thank you so much for the privilege of speaking to this august body. Many of you know my personal passions of advocating for individuals experiencing homelessness, those with mental illness, and those with substance use disorder. I believe in lending my voice to any vulnerable population, and tonight, as a lifelong rider and lover of horses, I was honored that Catherine asked me to speak to you about soaring. What she told you was pretty graphic, and that is what we in Animal Rescue deal with daily. I've read that soaring is described as forcing an Olympian to wear broken glass in her shoes so the pain will make her leap higher over the hurdles. You know how much it hurts when you tear your fingernail? These horses' hooves are cut back to the quick and ridden over hard surfaces to make them so tender they lie in their stalls in pain and are forced to get up by rough handling. If you've ever had skin cancer burned off, imagine multiplying that feeling 1,000 times all over your legs, but with diesel fuel, kerosene, and other caustic agents. What if these techniques were used to train your family dog, like Cooper? The outrage would be overwhelming and the practice would stop. Just because horses don't typically share a couch with their owners makes them no less sensitive to pain and fear at the hands of unscrupulous and vicious trainers. These beautiful animals have such a lovely natural gait, and for whatever reason, cheap blue ribbons have become the price for torturing horses into performing something so strange and unnatural as the aforementioned big lick. My friends on Metro Council, please pass a resolution tonight endorsing the Prevention of All Soaring Techniques Act, which is endorsed by hundreds of groups of veterinarians, prosecuting attorneys, sheriffs, and others with interests in horses, including the American Veterinary Medical Association. Kentucky and Tennessee have more soaring violations than any other state. I applaud Nashville City Council for passing a similar resolution to this one. It will urge our senators, one of whom has the power to bring it to a vote, to pass this legislation that will end the horribly failed system of self-policing in the industry, strengthen penalties for soaring, and prohibit Machiavellian devices from being used on these breeds of horses. The pads and the chains are essential to soaring. The Horse Protection Act prohibited this practice decades ago, but an ineffective amendment allowed amateur inspectors at shows, many of whom are paid off, to overlook soaring. The PAST Act amends the HPA to require independent inspectors trained by the Department of Agriculture. I would like you to think of these gentle giants who are permanently lamed for the sake of prize money, who are emotionally damaged from the cruel treatment of humans, and who have extraordinary pain for the rest of their lives throughout their bodies, as a result of the distortion of their stride and the stress on their muscles, tendons, and ligaments. They deserve better, and we need to make sure they are protected. We call ourselves a compassionate city, and the title of Horse Capital of the World extends across the Commonwealth. Thank you for listening and for supporting the resolution to endorse the passage.